Look what I've got in the mail today. I've got me enamel pins. My very first enamel pins that I've ordered. Oh, I don't know what to expect. I hope they're good. They've taken a while to get here. They've taken like 3 months. 2-3 months to get here. So, fingers crossed they're good. I got 4mm ones, so I'm hoping that they're quite big. We'll see. We'll have a look and we'll see how they are. I cannot wait to open them. So exciting. Right, let's open this up. I hope these are my enamel pins. They feel like my enamel pins. It's going to be funny, isn't it, if it's like a completely different parcel inside. Right, lift tab to open quickly. I think I'll just cut it, thanks. Oh, it's a parcel within a parcel. So I ordered 100 of these. I'm just hoping that the design wasn't a bit too big for how many millimetres I got it. I got it in the biggest size that they offered. So, oh, the suspense. Wow! Oh, I'm so impressed. I got a gold thingy for them. What do you call it? The outline. I got them a gold one, so that's just, oh my gosh, they look amazing. I was so worried about how these would look, especially because like I've never made one before and I didn't print out to see how big they were. Oh, look at that! What? I'm so impressed. Honestly, I am so impressed. I can't even. Look at them! They're so big as well. Like, they're not too big, but like they're just like the perfect size. Because I was thinking, oh no, they're going to be tiny and I put way too much like bits of detail on. And look at it! Look at it! Let me bring it up closer. Look at that! It's so pretty! Oh, I'm so happy with them. I can't wait to make some backing cards for them as well. Let's take it out. Oh, look at that! Oh, I am impressed. I am impressed. So I got these made from a company called The Enamel Factory. And they were really good. The communication was really good. Obviously, it took a while for them to come, which they said was out of the ordinary. And they gave me like a little bit of a discount because it took so long. But I am very, very impressed with them. Very impressed. I'll definitely use them again. And then I've got two little pink butterfly clasps. Very impressed. Now I just gotta figure out how to make a decent backing card for these guys. And then there's also a thing of organising them into seconds and firsts, which I've heard with enamel pins. They did say some of them might have some imperfections. Well, I'll go through them all and see which ones, but very impressed with them. Good, good. Now I'm gonna go on to making some backing cards for them. So this, I just found a business card that I have. This is just a sample from a company, just to see how it would look on a business card. I honestly thought it would be too big for a business card, but it seems to look like it'll fit pretty well. So I've done that, and then I've just made a quick template. This is just on paper, just to see, and now that's what I've got. So now I've just sent a load to a printer, and I'm just going to wait to a printing company. And then just wait for them to come. And then I can start putting them on backing cards. So I've done them two. And then just for the first few, I've printed it out on my printer. So I'll cut these out and put some of the pins on. And then I can get started straight away with photographs before the actual business cards come. I'll see if they're much better quality than this, but hey-ho, we'll just see how it goes. I cannot cut a straight line to save my life, honest to God. I mean, the printer hasn't printed them straight, but I'm just awful. I don't know why I can't seem to cut out. And as well, these scissors are material scissors, so probably won't be able to use these on material again. Blunted them. Oh no, probably blunted them completely. Thank you. Now I'm just gonna figure out which ones are first, seconds and thirds. Whew. This one's definitely gonna be a third. I don't even think I'll even put this one out. I'll probably just fill that in with resin and then keep it myself. See the yellow on the tail? Wow, that's like the enamel hasn't even gone in. That's mad. Ah, look at that. You can see like scratch marks of where like the enamel needs to be. It's almost like it's snapped off. Wow, I've not seen that before. I'll keep that one.
So there's been a bit of a break between the last bit of the video and this bit of the video. In fact, there's been like a huge break. In that time, I've literally changed my studio 2 times, moved house, and it's like, I don't know what happened, but now I'm settled. So now I'm gonna actually finish this video about my first time enamel pins, which I got basically last year. So I ordered the cards for it. I don't know if you saw in the last bit, and I finally ordered the business cards. They have been sitting for ages, and I'm like, oh my god, like finally I'm gonna sit down and actually do it properly. So let's get on with it. Let's finish this video that I've taken probably like 2 years. I've changed my hairstyle, changed everything, having a quarter life crisis. We're gonna get through this. We'll get through it.
Okay, so here is the box that I've got. So now open it up. Look at that. How cool do these look? And I got so many of them as well. I can't remember if I ordered like 100 or if I ordered maybe 2. I might have ordered 100 actually, but the quality is so much better on these ones than the ones that I made from a printer. Also, they're just cheaper in general. So I don't know if you can see that. There we go. Look at that. Look at that. Look at this as well. They get like a little cute case. You get like a really cute little carry case. Look at that. In fact, you get 2. Look at that. You get 2. Wow. Okay, so move you out of the way. I've decided that I'm gonna sort of make it really obvious which one's first, second, and third, just for me, because some of them I have to really like look at them and think, well, why have I put that in that pile? So this is how I've decided to do it. This is like a little gimmick that I've done. So this one, I believe, is this one is a second, and it's a second because she's got like a little mark on her leg that I can't get rid of. It's like a little orange mark. It's not really noticeable, but I can see it, and I wouldn't be happy sort of, you know, selling this as a first. So this one is a second, so I'll put you there. Also, please excuse my hands. Like, I've been working, I've just got loads of dark wood stain on it and burnt wood stuff on it. So they look gross, but I have washed them, I scrubbed them, but they're still pretty gross. Anyway, so I've got where's my third one? Ah, so this one is gonna be a third, because you can see quite badly the defect on it. So on this one, for me, it's got marks on it, and there's also this chip out of the enamel as well. So for me, that's definitely a third. So that one's third. Now, be great if we can get autofocus on this, wouldn't it, instead of manual focus. Let's keep it in one place. Okay, so we have third, second, and then I also want to just get a first, just to show you what I do. So this one for me is gonna be a first. I can't really see any defects on it. So what I do is I will keep the pink butterfly clasps on the first ones. On the second ones, I'm gonna take these off very difficultly. Okay, I'm gonna take them off, that one's second. And then I'm gonna take these ones off. Okay, so that's the third one. And now I've got these, which is just butterfly backs just to make badges, which I wanted to do with my shrinky wrap stuff, but I figured I'd be able to find out easier which one's which. So for the seconds, I'm gonna use the gold ones, and for the thirds, I'm gonna use the silver ones, so it'll make it much easier when I'm trying to actually pack them, which one's which. Ta-da! So there we go, so there's my 3 different types. There's my first, seconds, and my third. So I'll be able to find out easily which ones are which when they're in the packaging. So now I'm going to put them onto these cards, and then I'm gonna put them in a little cellophane packet. So there we go. So I've got these ones ready, and then I'm going to pack them in these little cellophane packets, which is that size, which is so hard to try and find what the actual size is. I think I've bought like about 3 packs before I actually realised what the actual size is that I need. And it's these ones, because it just gives it a little bit of leeway for the backs as well. There we go. These red things, oh my god, they are so annoying. Okay, so we'll do that, and then printed off these really cute little tiny logo stickers that I've got. I actually printed these off for little squares of chocolate that I had that I put into orders. However, found out that chocolate does not do well with heat and it was melting. So I changed that for sweets instead, for like vegan sweets. And now I'm just left with like a load of these stickers, and I was like, what can I use these for? And they'd fit perfectly on the back, just as, you know, a little extra. Look at that. They fit perfectly. They'll be fine. I know I don't want to waste things, so I'll reuse them for them. And I'll just put these in there. And then I can have them then. And then I can just literally, if somebody orders, I can just go and get them. Get rid of these horrible red things that stick to you. They're so static. And I can have them like little in little piles then, so I know which ones are which. But then I can just be like, oh, which one is it? That one. I could write on the back. I suppose that would also be good as what's first, second and third, but I don't know. I think it just looks a bit more professional. I know the silver ones probably are going to look a bit weird with the gold lining, but it is a third. So they'll be far cheaper than the firsts. There we go. Look at that. So cute. All professionally packed. Look at that.
So I've packed them, so now I just had to find like a storage solution for them. And I love this storage solution. Like, it's so good. It's like little cardboard boxes, like little bins that you get from retail. So this is kind of like where I'm gonna have my products. Obviously, it's not finished yet. It's still an absolute tip. However, look how cute these boxes are. Like, I think it was Catnip who, like, had a link to these boxes, and they are so good. Like, they fit amazing, and it's on the eyeball shelf from IKEA, and you just like kind of slot these shelves into the place that you want them, and it works perfectly. It works absolutely perfectly. So I'll send the link of where I got them from and where I found out about them. But look at that. And then I literally just, because I didn't want to, you know, I don't think this would stick in there, so I folded a piece of card over, put double-sided sticky tape on each side, and then I just put that on. Look at that. Now, I know you can see like a few empty ones, except for like this one. This one's just like little extra gifts that I like to put into my parcels. However, I'm hoping that these sell, because then I can get more. To be honest, even if they don't sell, I will probably make more, so I can fill these up, because I've got loads of these boxes. So yeah, I really like it. It's so cute. It's so organised. Not that bit. Don't look at that bit. That bit's organised. Oh, that bit. Just that middle shelf, that's very organised. There's nothing really in there, but it's organised for now. So that's it. That's this video all done. Finally, after like 2 years, I finally got this finished. I got all my enamel pins. They're all nice and packed. Look at them. I'm so happy for them. I'm so happy they came out the way they did. I absolutely love how they came out. I'll leave a link in the description below of where I got these from. They were a really good price, and for what I got, you know, I'm very, very happy with them. I honestly thought they'd be too small. I thought they'd be like, you know, just not good. I don't know why, but I'm really glad that this turned out really well. And now I can finally put them for sale. Whether or not they sell is a different matter entirely, but I really enjoyed the process, and I really enjoyed ordering my first enamel pins. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave a like or a comment in the section below, and I hope I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye, guys.